La radio des classiques du rock et de la pop.
Good afternoon and welcome.
Thank you.
Bienvenue à tous les trois, puisque en studio nous avons Debbie Harry, nous avons Chris Stein et Hello. Nous avons Clem Burke.
Hello, bonjour.
Hello.
Trois des membres fondateurs donc de Blondie. C'est assez extraordinaire de les retrouver X années après encore dans un tel état. How long is this tour? La tournée dure combien de temps?
It was 6 weeks and today is actually the last show.
Last show.
We're starting up again September 5th in the States with the US band called X. Do we know X in France?
I don't think so, no, in Belgium.
Been around since the LA punk rock band called X.
What's the secret about writing pop songs, perfect pop songs? Like Parallel Lines, for instance. If you take the album, it's absolutely perfect. It's the real perfect pop songs.
I think, it's different because of the context. Back in those days, everybody didn't have access to everything. So there were people that didn't know what the Shangri-Las were even. You know, there was lots of stuff that people weren't familiar with. Now, all the kids hear everything all at once. So writing a pop song, I think now in 2013, is different than it was in 1978.
Was it easier at that time?
I think it was easier to surprise people back then.
C'était peut-être plus facile de surprendre les gens à l'époque. À l'époque, tout le monde ne connaissait pas les Shangri-Las, par exemple. Ben, eux, ils ont peut-être eu plus facile que les groupes de maintenant. Maintenant, c'est vrai que c'est il y a un côté universel. When you release something now, it's released for the whole world, in fact.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
As soon as it's released one time, it's gone. It's out there, you know.
As soon as we play them one time, and everyone knows.
What about your collaboration with Beth Ditto?
Oh yes, it was wonderful. We've known Beth for a long time. I think she opened for us at the Bumper Shoot Festival in Seattle quite a few years ago. And I've always loved the fact that she, as a vocalist, is treated as an instrument. And with her wonderful voice, her unique sound, it's especially beautiful.
This new record is a lot of collaboration, a lot of people, and more than ever before.
Il y a beaucoup plus de collaborations que dans le temps. Il y a la collaboration avec Beth Ditto qu'il connaissait puisque en fait il s'était rencontré à un festival à Seattle, Bumper Shoot Festival, et depuis lors ils se connaissent, ils ont travaillé ensemble. Je signale quand même que elle apparaît sur le single "Arrows by Any Name". A few words about this new single. Quelques mots à propos de ce nouveau 45 tours, enfin 45 tours, single.
It was written by Matt Katz-Bowen. And it was a track that lyrically was probably in the music as well, inspired by the birth of his daughter, his young child. And he wrote it before she was born. So in the chorus it says, if you're a boy or a girl, it doesn't matter to him because, you know, he didn't know what to expect. So it was very charming and had a lot of meaning.
Donc en fait, Matt, qui fait partie du groupe, a écrit le morceau à l'époque où sa femme était enceinte. Il ne savait pas encore que c'était une petite fille qu'il allait avoir. Et il a écrit le morceau avec les paroles « Are you a boy or a girl? I love you just the same. It's a, your kind of I love you just the way you are. »
Yes.
There's also ambiguous part to it, sexual ambiguity as well.
It's funny because some movements could use this track.
Right. Yes,
so
of course.
It's for everyone.
Yeah, we know that.
Because it's not a...
What was that old song? Are you a boy or are you a girl? What was that?
That's the Barbarians.
Yeah.
The Barbarians.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oui, effectivement, il y avait aussi les Barbarians qui chantaient ça, You're a boy or a girl.
Very popular in France, the Barbarians. Malty with the hook.
Yeah.
The drummer with the hook hand.
Avec le crochet, oui. Le batteur avec le crochet.
Malty.
Et en fait, donc Matt, qui fait partie du groupe, a écrit ce morceau qui sonne tout à fait comme Blondie. It sounds like a Blondie single. It's funny because you didn't write it, but it sounds like as if you wrote it yourself.
Well, we've been working with Matt for about 5 years, and
he's embedded in the band.
Yeah, he's a traditional New York...
He was a real
musician, you know, and I think he has the same kind of sensibility. And I think once you hear the whole album, we're calling it Download, A Ghost of a Download is the title of the album. And I think once you hear it, you'll, I consider it to be as equal to Parallel Lines. It's very similar, a lot of songs.
But I think we'll have to wait 20 years for people to figure that out.
I'm telling them now.
Because, you know, when Parallel Lines first came out, I don't know if everybody was going, oh, this is a classic album of all time.
That's true.
30 years later, people say that. Whatever.
As a matter of fact, when we handed in Parallel Lines, the record company did not like it. They said
that was their job.
They said, we don't hear any singles.
No, that was the next. That was Automatic.
No, Parallel Lines too.
That's what they said.
But Auto American, the record that had Rapture and Tide Is High on it, when we gave it to them, they said, we don't hear any singles on this.
But they said that about Parallel Lines too.
The interesting thing about Parallel Lines is that the first single was cover song, a Buddy Knox, I'm Gonna Love You Too, Buddy Holly song.
Yeah.
That's what the record company chose. And, you know, interestingly enough,
the least remembered song on the record.
But interestingly enough, you know, back in the day, you've probably been in radio for a while. With vinyl, you usually put your most desirable commercial songs, first, second, third on it. By the time the programmer got to the third song, if he didn't like it, he'd toss the record out the window, right? And therefore, but look at this, Heart of Glass is like number 8. It's buried in the album. Yeah. So we thought we were being experimental with that. It wasn't like we thought, oh, yes, we've recorded this
disco
pop
hit,
disco
yeah.
hit, and it's going to be yeah. a big hit. It was like buried in the record, so go figure.
The record was in America. The record was on the charts for 6 months
It was
on the charts for 6 months before Heart of Glass came out.
Yeah, it was like almost in the U.S. Billboard charts for a year.
Yeah,
which is great. You know, like now it's the antithesis of that. Now something comes out, gets blown up overnight, and goes away by the next week. You know, it's kind of real short shelf life, I guess you would call it.
Yeah, maybe.
Donc en fait, c'était totalement différent. C'est vrai qu'on a évoqué Parallel Lines, qui était l'album parfait, un classique du rock pop avec des tas de singles dessus. Alors ce qui est quand même extraordinaire, c'est que Debbie dit, oui mais attention, à l'époque, la firme de disques nous disait, oui, il n'y a pas de single là-dessus, on va avoir du mal à trouver. Finalement, il y a des morceaux tels que Heart of Glass qui était 8e. On sait très bien qu'à l'époque du vinyle, on mettait en première ou deuxième position le titre qu'on allait sortir en single, donc est sorti d'abord le single avec la reprise de Buddy Holly, et les autres, c'est venu peu à peu. L'album est resté un an dans les charts, ce qui est absolument extraordinaire aussi, puisque maintenant, après une semaine, on n'en parle plus, et il y a eu 6 mois entre la sortie et la sortie de Heart of Glass. Donc c'est dire si le traitement d'un album était totalement différent.